No!
Oh, God.
I'm talking about the Quran! I'm talking about the people voices
in the Quran! This is the subject matter here! Runaway fool! Go around to your stool pigeon, friend!
I rebuke you, Cain! You need to repent!
Listen, the Lord is going to deal with you. The Lord is going to deal with you.
Yes, with you.
The Lord is going to deal with you.
With you!
Right.
With you.
I'm talking about the Quran.
Hey, I know. I have all the texts, bro. What yeah. It's about me.
Ashraf. Meanwhile, them you want to come and attack our Christians, blaspheme the name of Jesus Christ.
Argument.
Yeah.
Him left it and a pipe on me. Oh, you this and you that.
Ashraf.
So this week,
Muslims.
Last week, I don't business with
Muslims.
Come to me and I say, oh, you love.
He knows
love, right?
That you're going to engage him.
You love, right?
This is what
you
he's
love,
trying
right?
to do. Do not let him do it.
You can't stop him from engaging.
Do not let him do this.
From engaging.
I'm talking about the Quran.
Brother,
do you have a peaceful voice from the Quran?
I don't care.
Are you a Muslim?
If you think about it, what would Jesus say about this whole situation?
Right. Okay.
What would Jesus say about this whole situation?
He'd what?
Say,
are you Jesus? Are you Jesus?
No, but
there you go.
I think I know, like, he'd
there
say,
you go.
Other,
prove to me from the Bible that what I'm doing is wrong.
You're not doing wrong.
You can't.
But it's not loving.
You
like,
can't.
Where's the love, man? Where's the unity of love?
Jesus walked into the temple and he turned over tables. Why? Because he captured the heart of God. And he saw the evil and he wanted to rebuke the devil and tear down arguments in the name of his heavenly Father and show people where they're going wrong. How dare you come in and try to teach me about Christianity? I know my Bible. You need to seek the Lord, my brother. Where are you Muslims? Defend your prophet. Your prophet has left you marching orders. Your prophet has left you marching orders to slay the idolater wherever you find him. Do you agree with it?
Okay, defend your Jesus that he was.
Don't change the subject. Your prophet has left you marching orders. Now, Jesus Christ, our Savior, his marching orders will go ye therefore into all the world, making disciples of all men, teaching them to follow what I've taught you. Blessed are the peacemakers, he said.
The peacemakers.
Yes, the peacemakers. What did Muhammad leave you? What were his marching orders? What were his marching orders? Slay the idolater wherever you find him. Has he been abrogated? No. Kill the mushrikun wherever you find him. Has it been abrogated? No. Fight those who don't believe in Allah and the last day until they pay the jizya and feel themselves the Jude. Has it been abrogated? No.
How many Bible have you got?
Which means, ISIS, Hezbollah,
Hamas,
Al-Shabaab, all the extreme terrorist groups are following his command. And inwardly, every Muslim who knows the Quran knows this. I was over here last week and I asked in the darkness if any Muslim was shouting Allahu Akbar when the guy went to London Bridge and pulled out that knife. And somebody said yes. A Muslim said yes. And he knew he was in the darkness. That's why he could get away with it. You should be ashamed of yourself, Muslim. You should be ashamed of yourself.
If he actually followed Islam, would he have done that?
How many Bible have you got? Go to London Museum. Go to you will find 500 Bible.
I'm not even Islamic.
That's all they have. They can't address the topic of what I'm speaking about. Sir, would you like to address the topic I'm speaking about?
What about the Christian guy who...
No, don't say what about. Don't say what about. Don't say what about. I can speak about it afterwards.
The other guy, the Christian guy.
That's what it is. You can't address the topic I'm talking about. So let me take him on to Christianity. I'll answer any questions about Christianity.
No.
Anything.
What do you think about first. What do you think about this
that
guy
person.
Who did the
right,
same
okay.
in New Zealand?
He wasn't a Christian, he was an ethno-nationalist.
He confessed
by his own mouth that he wasn't a Christian, right? And there is no instruction in the Bible which says go slaughter to 52 Muslims, not one. There is no instruction in the Bible which justifies killing 52 Muslims. But there is instruction in the Quran which justifies going to blow up the Manchester Arena.
Perfect.
What is the justification?
Somebody challenge me. Tell me I'm wrong.
What is the justification? Tell me.
Brother.
Give me the ayah.
Show me a peaceful verse.
You have to prove me. You are saying. I'm not saying. You
I have asked a question. You're here, sir. Right. I've asked you to show me a piece. Do you know your Quran? Do you know the Quran?
Can you just come down?
Do you know the Quran?
Not
then you shouldn't be here. Read your Quran. Read your Quran.
Jesus has no clothing. What
about read your Quran. Because you know what's in there, that's why you're here.
No, no, just tell me.
You know what's in your Quran.
No, tell me, tell me.
I'm not a fool. You need to go and find an ignorant.
No, no, just tell me what is there. Just tell me what
I'm
you
disgusted.
Are.
Disgusted. I'm disgusted. You and just, it takes some who is willing to stand up for the Lord Jesus. Who?
Amen.
Regardless of reprisals, who is willing?
Amen.
Everybody wants to walk around. Say no, yes, don't be divisive. Don't be, let's love everybody. Let's roll daisy chains. Nonsense. We're not living in a hippie commune. This is real lives. Real lives. This is a real book that is sending people to blow themselves up and take out knives and kill indiscriminately. It's a real mandatory sanction by a prophet, so-called nutcase that died 1400 years ago, which Muslims are living by today. And you need to take this seriously. Take it seriously. Because there are not all of us are ignorant. Not all of us are ignorant.
The prophet, his wife was Christian.
But not all of us are willing to speak up. Not all of us are willing to speak up.
Who gave the freedom to all Christians. Black people? Who gave them this opportunity to feel they are free?
Bilal.
Do you know who is Bilal?
Disgusting. Disgusting.
Do you know who is
Bilal?
He wants to change
slave.
The subject.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me destroy his argument straight away.
Yeah, go.
Bilal was a slave.
Yeah.
Bilal was even set free by Muhammad.
Nah.
Bilal was ordered to go up and do the call to
you
prayer. He wasn't set free. He was ordered. And he even when he asked Muhammad to free him, Muhammad died and left him like a slave. Look at him run. Look at him
good
run.
Good try.
Black people are still denigrated in Islam because
heads.
Of the Arab religion.
Look at me,
we are called Abid.
Racing heads.
We are called Abid.
Hello. Tell me something about Trump, the Christian Trump.
I'm talking about peaceful verses in the Quran.
In general, about weapon, about hey, everything. What they
was
are
Muhammad
doing,
black?
This Christian. I'm not changing anything.
Do you know what's the topic? Do you know what's the topic?
Muslims, you need to repent. You need to turn away.
Yes.
Turn away from the sinful life that Muhammad has told you is okay. Turn away from your wife beating. Turn away from your child molesting. Turn away from your prostitution. Turn away from your polygamy and turn to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Turn to Jesus Christ.
Merry Christmas, Muslims.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas,
He's your
God.
Savior. He is your Savior. He came down here and he died. He died and took your punishment. He took my punishment so that we wouldn't have to suffer. So that we could have eternal life. Believe in him. Believe in him and you will be saved. And I know there's Muslims listening to me.
So, I ask you one question. You have got 500 Bible.
Go and read
which one we
the
have
words
to
of Jesus. Go and read the words of Jesus.
Which one?
Which one? Which Bible?
The words of healing.
Which Bible?
And peace.
You have got
mercy,
so many Bibles.
Love.
I'm confused.
And forgiveness.
Which Quran you read?
Read the real words that God wants to speak to you.
Have wash or duty?
When God sends a messenger, when a God sends a messenger to this world, he does not send a messenger to take. He sends a messenger to serve. To give.
That's right.
Muhammad took everything. He's even taken your freedom, Muslims. He's told you how to comb your hair, how to eat, how to sleep with your wife.
Go to the toilet.
There is no freedom in Islam.
You don't teach your son how to
set you free.
That's right.
He came to set you free.
Amen.
And if you believe in him, you'll be free indeed.
Amen.
Turn to Jesus.
Amen. Turn to Jesus,
Amen.
Uncle.
Run to Jesus Christ.
Amen. Merry Christmas,
so,
Uncle.
Run to Jesus.
Amen. If Jesus is God, why he say, why God, you leave me alone?
You're following a man that said it was all right to take a 9-year-old into his bed.
No.
You're following a man that said it was okay to take a 9-year-old into his bed. Are you sure? Really? Are you sure?
You're a liar!
Are you sure? This is the best of mankind! Are you sure?
You're a liar!
Check the data! like my brother Kryptonite says, put him under the microscope.
Yes. We got Kryptonite.
God bless you.
See what filth calls out.
Liar!
I can't refute you! Liar!
That's all you got. That's all you got, yeah.
Because they're taught, when they have no answers, to just defend. Defend parrot fashion. Oh, dear Muslims, you are taught from since you were a baby to hate.
You're a liar!
You are taught from since you were a baby that Jews and Christians mean you no well. This is not true! It's not true!
And you don't know who's your God! One day you want them to say son of God!
Check your heart! You all have a conscience! Check your heart!
How many Bible have you got?
You know it is not right to hate your fellow human being! You know! And that is God in you! That is God's spirit in you! Giving you a direction to Him! And causing you to question the prophet you're following.
Do you love Muslims?
Question him. Because he wasn't sent by God. I love all of you guys. That's why I'm here.
Yeah, we love Muslims.
That's why I'm here.
Merry Christmas, Muslims.
That's why I'm here.
Oh God, why are you in
this? Do you love Christians?
Which God are you talking about?
Hello? Do you love Christians?
Uncle, do you love us?
No, I just
don't Muhammad
died.
No answer.
Nothing.
Yo, Muhammad died.
No answer. Oh, yeah,
uncle. How many God you have God?
The devil wants to be in the God.
How many God you have God?
If you have knowledge.
How many Bible you have God?
Stand here.
And why Jesus is born? He born in
Medina. I would urge the Muslims who are listening to me. The Muslims who are listening to me, who maybe don't know that much about the Hadith, who don't know that much about the Quran, please, please, don't listen to what your Imams tell you.
Jesus, he was worshiping him.
Take control of your eternal destiny. Take control of your life and do your own research. Look into the life of the man that has convinced you that he's perfect.
Praise the Lord.
Look into his life. What kind of a man will tell you, have a break. I'll never take a break. I'll take a break when I'm dead. Listen, what kind of a man, when you bring him water to do absolution, and there is dead dogs, there's women's periods.
Wow.
There is excrement in it.
Wow.
Who will say to you that water is pure.
Wow.
Yeah. Is this the best scientist you could muster?
The lie?
A man that has convinced you that anything he says is from God. Is that statement from God?
No way.
You can go into your toilet and drink that water. Is that man from God who's telling you that?
Wow. Disgusting, disgusting.
Is that man from God who's going to tell you that if you lift your eyes to heaven while you're praying, you're going to go blind?
Wow.
Is that a prophet? Is that a prophet? What? Is there a prophet? Come on.
False and deceiver.
He is trying to control you. He is trying to order everything about your life because he's afraid that you're going to leave. Muslims go around and they boast, we are the fastest growing religion.
We are.
But the reason is not what you think. Because there are millions and millions of Muslims who are too afraid to leave. Because of the fear that Muhammad has put of a death penalty if you leave Islam.
That's right.
They're afraid of being ostracized by their family and their loved ones.
Yeah.
That's right.
They're afraid of being hacked down in the street.
How do you know that?
Because all you have Muslims is your community. I understand, but you've got to be men about it. You've got to be men about it. Because this is your eternal destiny. And you've got to make tough decisions. You gotta make tough choices. Turn away from Islam. Run to Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
I'm done.